So right after we left Nick and Helen's, we went to this really cute little shop in Mangatapere. The first two nights freedom camping, we stayed in Takura Beach. It was Miles's absolute favorite. There's a Maori man that lived on the beach, and he seemed really nice. But when we first arrived, his dog came running with a whole rabbit head hanging out of his mouth. This is some food that Nick, Helen, and Susie all gave to Miles and I for our trip. They were so unbelievably generous, and we are so thankful. Miles and I began a hike called the Duke's Nose / Kayavara rock hike. It was around 7 miles long and, in my opinion, has been the most beautiful hike we've done thus far.
We're getting there.
To get to the lookout of the hike, we had to climb up these railing type things. They were fun to do, and the whole hike we were just talking about how we were so excited to climb them. I loosely point to where we hiked up to.
We own, baby. Oh yeah, like a fish. Woohoo!
A wild rat in the cliffs. You're gonna hit a log.
These birds were vying for Miles's fish and chips, and they were cornering us.
Yeah. I'm scared. Oh, there they go. That one's dedicated, though. That one's very dedicated.
We'll be right back. Miles and I headed up towards the most northern part of New Zealand on Cape Ranga. We spent the night in Spirits Bay. It's crazy to think these horses just were living on like the most beautiful countryside ever, and they didn't even know it. You may not be able to see it very well, but that dark blob in the water is a stingray. Miles called out to me because it almost touched him, and I sprinted over and lost my sunglasses in the process, but it was so cool to see. And there's just like tons of stingrays in New Zealand. I've been getting familiar with more garden plant varieties. This is silver beet, and it was really fun to cook with. So this is the most northern tip of New Zealand. It's Cape Ranga and has a famous lighthouse there. The beautiful mixing of blue in the water is the result of warm and cool currents coming together. According to the Maori, the spirits across the New Zealand islands come to this northernmost part, Cape Ranga, to depart when they die, to return to their homelands in the Pacific Islands. Miles recently taught me cribbage, and I've been getting very into it. We hiked the Pinnacles hike in the Coromandel Peninsula. It was so rainy. Dang. I really didn't record much of it. And this was the top of it, and we couldn't really see anything. But there were very cool bridges, and it was a good workout, if nothing else.
It. You already know.
Whoa.
It's bouncy.
I was obsessed with these little pigs. They were on the side of the road in this casual kind of place called Stu's Animal Sanctuary or something like that. This pig was the only one that let me pet him. Afterwards, though, Miles reminded me that these pigs did not look very sanitary, and I could get the swine flu or something like that. These pigs were straight feasting on these whole fish carcasses. You can see the spine of one in the background. It was hilariously disturbing. These are cowrie trees. They're quite massive. Right now, they're a bit endangered in New Zealand because they were chopped down for wood with no thought put into how slow their growth time is. Cathedral Cove is an iconic New Zealand landmark. It's this giant cave that looks very cathedral-like.
And that poop just exploded.
This is a Portuguese man of war. It's often mistaken for a jellyfish, but it's actually a siphonophore. For the night, Miles and I camped outside a cemetery in a freedom camping spot. For breakfast, we went to this fun little restaurant that looked like it was inside of a house. It was called Egg Centric. New Zealand is basically just a string of volcanoes on top of each other, so it has a lot of geothermic activity. So that geothermic activity made this beach pretty dang hot when you dig into it. That's why it's called Hot Water Beach. It was kind of a madhouse, as you can see, but we had a lot of fun. Te Puna Quarry Park was very adorable. It reminded me a lot of the Rose Garden in Portland, Oregon. The next day, we saw this boat being towed by this tractor, which I thought perfectly summed up New Zealand and was just so funny. We were in the town of Mount Manganui, and there was a triathlon going on, which we kind of eavesdropped on. We climbed Mount Manganui, which is basically a mountain on the end of a peninsula. It's very striking to see.
Oh yeah.
We drove to Lake Taupo, which is where our next Wwoofing destination would be, but it was downpouring rain as we were driving. Thanks for listening. We appreciate you guys so much.